Yo, yo, Griffin Nation, I'm Chris Hernandez, and welcome to the 100th edition of On the Hill with Hernandez. We have highlights of women's basketball and their conference opener last Saturday versus Goldey-Beacom College. These two squared off in last year's season finale in the infamous coin flip game. Griffins lost that contest 89-72 and were forced to play Bloomfield on the road, but in 2017, starting out 1-0 is a huge first step. CHC defense is ready to go in the first minute of play. Glenn with the steal and Tumaz with the lay-in. Tamaya Graham right here with the offensive board and goes straight back up for the bucket. Mary Trossi drives baseline and she'll get bumped, converts at the line for 3 points. End of the first, Wild Goose with the screen. Tumaz wide open, she'll knock it down first of the game. Start of the second, Mary Pock on Cassie Siebold. Good defense, but even better offense. Griff's up for it. 5 minutes later, Tumaz takes the body on the other end. 2:30 left in the half, Siebold to Gibson. CHC ends the second quarter on a 17-3 run, 13-point lead at the break, but the Scarlet and Gold were not done yet. Tumaz went 6-for-9 from the floor and shot 66% from three. 17 points in the second half led to a career-high 29 points from the senior. From a senior to two new players, Kate Dougherty with the first points of her career. Final 20 seconds, Mary Bode puts 2 points to her Division II resume as well. Bounce back win for the Griffs with the final score of 77-53. Whole team effort from the Scarlet and Gold. All but three players made it on the stat sheet. Along with Tumaz's 29, Siebold yet again posted 12, and Gibson finished with 10. The defense was very stingy, and they were stingy as ever, causing 34 turnovers, which translated to 31 points. A key to the victory was putting Brittany Bryson in a box. She averaged 15 points heading into the game, but she was virtually invisible, going 3-for-14 from the field with only 7 points. Here's what head coach Mike West had to say about the win and this week's schedule.
I think the game was in the pace. That's what we wanted to be. We wanted to create pace both offensively and defensively. So we wanted to speed them up with our press. And likewise, we wanted to play fast as we always do. And I think we did a really good job of that for 40 minutes. I just don't think that there was ever a moment where it was slow. So I think that was the big difference in the game tonight. It's always, I mean, now you get to say you're in first place and you're undefeated. So now the goal is to stay there. So the challenge isn't any more of, you know, try to get in the first or try to stay undefeated. We're there, so we got to maintain it. So it's good. It's always good. Well, I mean, we're not trying to figure out how many we're going to get. We got to take it one game at a time. But the reality is this week poses a big challenge for us in the sense that, yeah, the last two defending champions were playing and arguably the top teams in our division. So if we want to earn a home playoff game or you want to win a divisional title, we got to beat them. So it's a nice opportunity to see where we measure early on in the year. So looking forward to it. But the only thing that matters right now is Jefferson. We're not worried about sciences. Right now we focus on Jefferson and try to take care of business on Tuesday.
You heard the man. This week is very, very important and it's huge. Jefferson University tonight and sciences on Saturday. We're interested in tonight's matchup with the Rams in the Gallagher Center. We split last year's series with a 72-51 loss, but a 75-69 win at home. But in 2018, the Rams are 7-1 overall and are 1-0 in the conference. On the floor, Jefferson has some pretty effective players. Leading scorer is senior Erin Mayer with 11.9 points per game, but keep an eye out for junior guard Jessica Kaminsky. She's shooting 40.3% from the field. Another player to watch off the bench is freshman Caitlin Cunningham, who is averaging 7.1 a game in 17.3 minutes a game. Listen, our offense will provide the scoring at one point or another. I believe this game is won with our defensive effort. The Rams are averaging 16 offensive boards per game. That's the second most as a team in the CAC. We're allowing 16.8 so far in 7 contests. Bossing out and pushing the ball in transition is how we play. Staying true to our identity will put us in great position for success. As always, maintaining our energy level is very critical. Remaining engaged with every possession, every shot, and every play is very important. There is no sense in looking toward sciences without completing the task at hand. This is a huge test for CHC, and they'll see where we measure up against the conference elite. That's all for today. Thanks for spending some time with me on the Hill. I'm Chris Hernandez, and I'll see you next time.